Hello children, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and doing well in this lockdown period. Now here is another video of the chapter Reproduction in Plants. The topic is seed dispersal, or also you can say dispersal of seeds. So what is dispersal of seeds? That is the process by which seeds and the fruits are scattered away from the parent plant is called dispersal of seeds. Parent plant means the plant from which the seed and fruits are produced. And what happens in seed dispersal? That the seed get scattered away from the parent plant. Seeds and the fruits, they move from one place to another or away from the parent plant. So now here the question is that why is this dispersal of seed is necessary? And what is the importance of dispersal of seed in plants? So children, I want to explain you here that as you all know that plants cannot move from one place to another. So what happens? The fruits and the seeds will start falling at the same place. So what will happen if too many seeds are planted at the same place? Then there will be shortage of nutrients. Okay, they won't be able to germinate or grow properly. So to survive well and to grow healthy, there is a need of scattering of the seeds or the fruits. Now, as you know that plants cannot move from one place to another, so there will be some sort of medium. Okay, so these are the the agents of dispersal. They are known as the agents of dispersal, and they are the natural ones. Here there are four kinds of you can say the ways also, or the agents also: animals and humans, water, splitting also known as the explosion or self dispersal, and the wind. Okay, so these are the four means or the agents of dispersal of seed. One by one I will explain you. I will also explain you that depending on the ways, what are the characteristic of the seeds and the fruits are. Okay. Now dispersal by wind. Okay. Wind work as an agent for the dispersal. So as you see, the seeds are very light weighted. This is the dandelion. The seeds are very light weighted because they have to get scattered with the help of the wind. So light seeds are easily carried away by the wind and to be dropped down at some other distant place where they germinate. So especially this is the seeds of cotton is also there. They are having the wings. These are the wings, or you might have seen also around you sometime floating in the air, this kind of structure moves. So this is the dispersal of the by the wind. Next is dispersal by water. Okay, so those plants which are near the water bodies, okay, they are generally dispersed by the water. So water transports these seeds from one place to another. And if you see this kind of a structure, this is the coconut fruit. Okay, they used to float over it. Okay, they are easily get floated. They do not sink under the water. That's why they are easily carried from one place to another, and then they are moved from the parent plant, very far from the parent plant. Okay, because it can be easily carried with the help of the waves of water. Next is the seed dispersal by animal. Okay, so animals and the birds, they eat the fruit and throw away the seeds on the ground where they germinate. Especially some of the plants, they are having the spines or the hooks, okay, spikes or the hooks, like xanthium. They also used to get stick to the hairy skin of the animals, and in most of the cases the seeds or the fruits are thrown and then they germinate anywhere, okay, when they get the favorable condition. Nowadays you will see that mangoes are there. Mango season is there, okay, and a whole year some of the fruits are eaten and then the seeds are thrown anywhere. Okay, so that is the way of dispersal of seeds by the human beings and the animals. Also, sometimes the seeds remain undigested, okay, after being eaten, and then they are excreted out by the birds. Okay, and you know that birds used to sit anywhere, so they release their waste material or undigested things, and that seeds will be also there. And that's why sometimes you see that on the big buildings, the walls, cracks of the walls are there, some plants are grown, okay, by themselves. Okay, so it is just because of the seed dispersal by the animals or the birds. And the last one is seed dispersal by explosion of the fruits. Some fruits are like that. What happens when they get ripe, then they get exploded. That's why sometimes this one is also known as the self-dispersal, because it happens by themselves. Okay, especially the peas are there, balsam is there, they burst when they ripe, and the force of explosion scatters the seeds in all the direction. So because of this, the seeds get scattered away from the parent plant and start growing anywhere. So students, hope you all have understood the topics. If you have any doubt or question, you can ask in the comment section below, and the remaining topics will be covered in the next videos. Please like, share it with your classmates, subscribe, and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you can get my latest updates. Thank you and take care.